I didn't know when I chose to be a performer that I would spend so much time away from home. That I had no idea that I was going to spend so much time in hotels. And, you know, I didn't know when I became a performer that I was dooming myself to an existence in these places where the hangers have no hooks. Oh, that's good. I don't want to be alone in this, people. Hotel hangers do not have hooks. You know, they have this little ring affair that slides on a bar. And the bottom of the ring has a little notch. And the top of the hanger, instead of having a hook, it has a little wart. And it fits into the notch. Hanging your clothes in a hotel is strictly a two-handed operation, people. With one hand, you must steady the ring. The other hand, you disengage the hanger. Meanwhile, you're holding your suit in your mouth. I'm frankly staggered when I contemplate the amount of energy that must have gone into this, the amount of effort and time and cost to finally come up with a way to make hanging clothes harder. I understand the man who invented the hookless hanger also holds a patent on an automobile door that opens inwards. How do you trust yourself to these people? How do you trust, you know, you've got to put your head down on that pillow and go to sleep in one of these places. One of these places that doesn't have a 13th floor, incidentally. That really, they believe there's something wrong with that, you know. And if you believe there's something wrong with that, don't stay on the 14th floor because you're asking for trouble. I mean, how do you trust yourself to these people? Do you remember when they used to have this little piece of paper that went around the seat? They don't have that anymore, except maybe in some little cheap hotels. Remember that? That sanitized for your protection? How did they go about doing that? I don't know what you envision. I envision masks and gowns and rubber gloves and stainless steel tools. They remove the toilet seat, take it downstairs, boil it for 20 minutes. You know what's kind of fun? If you ever find a hotel that still has these little pieces of paper around the seat, you know what you do? If you're staying there for a few days, it's really much better. First thing in the morning, you very carefully slide the strip off the seat. You put it down. You do everything you have to do. Just before you leave the room, you slide the strip back on. You'll find that on about the third day, the maid runs and hides when she spots you in the hall. If you're staying there for longer, on about the fourth day, you buttonhole her, see? You say, is it all right if I remove that strip? It's really terribly inconvenient. I'm going to do something for you now, which will indicate for you the kind of programmed mentality you're dealing with in these hotels. You're not going to change them, people. You're not going to get through. Dear maid, please do not leave any more of those little bars of soap in my bathroom, since I have brought my own bath size dial. Please remove the 6 unopened little bars from the shelf under the medicine cabinet and another 3 in the shower soap dish. They are in my way. Thank you, S. Berman. Dear room 635, I am not your regular maid. She will be back tomorrow, Thursday, from her day off. I removed the 3 hotel soaps from the shower soap dish as you requested. The 6 bars on the shelf I took out of your way and put on top of the Kleenex dispenser in case you should change your mind. This leaves only the 3 bars I left today, which my instructions from the management is to deliver 3 soaps daily. I hope this is satisfactory. If anything else comes up, please call Miss Carmen in the linen room. Sincerely yours, Kathy Relief Maid. Dear maid, I hope you are my regular maid. Apparently, Kathy did not tell you about my note to her concerning the little bars of soap. When I got back to my room this evening, I found you had added 3 little camés to the shelf under the medicine cabinet. I am going to be here in the hotel for a full 2 weeks and have brought my own bath size dial. So I won't need those 6 little camés which are now in the shelf. They are in the way when shaving, brushing teeth, etc. Please remove them. Thank you, S. Berman. Dear Mr. Berman, my day off was last Wednesday, so the relief maid left three hotel soaps, which we are instructed by the management. I took the six soaps, which were in your way on the shelf, and put them in the shower soap dish, where your dial was. I put the dial inside the medicine cabinet for your convenience. I did not remove the three complimentary soaps, which are always placed inside the medicine cabinet for all new check-ins, in which you did not object to when you checked in last Monday. Also, I did place three hotel soaps on your shelf, as per my instructions from the management, since you left no instructions to the contrary. Please let me know if I can be of any further assistance. Or call Miss Carmen in the linen room. Thank you. Have a pleasant stay, your regular maid, Dottie. Dear Mr. Berman, the assistant manager, Mr. Ken Setter, informed me this a.m. that you were unhappy with your maid service. I have assigned a new girl to your room. If I could be of any further assistance, please contact me so I can give it my personal attention. Please call extension 1108 between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. Thank you, Elaine Carmen, housekeeper. Dear Miss Carmen, it is impossible for me to contact you between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. since I leave the hotel for business at 7 a.m. and do not get back before 6 p.m. That's the reason I called Mr. Ken Setter last night. You were already off duty. I only asked Mr. Ken Setter if he could do anything about those little bars of soap. I did not want a new maid. The new maid you assigned me must have thought I was a new check-in today. Since she left another three bars of soap inside the medicine cabinet, along with her regular delivery of three bars on the shelf. In just 5 days here, I've accumulated 24 little bars of soap. I am beginning to dread the next 9 days. Why are you doing this to me? Asked Berman. Dear Mr. Berman, I've instructed your maid to stop delivering soap to your room and to remove the extra soap. If I could be of any further assistance, please contact me on extension 1108 between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. Thank you. Elaine Carmen, housekeeper. Dear Mr. Ken Setter, my bath-sized dial is missing. Every single bar of soap was taken from my room, including my own bath-sized dial. I came in late last night and had to call the bellhop to bring me a bar of soap so I could take a shower. He brought me four cashmere bouquets. S. Berman. Dear Mr. Berman, I have informed our housekeeper, Elaine Carmen, of your soap problem. I cannot understand why there were no soaps in your room, since our maids are instructed to leave three soaps each time they service a room. The situation will be rectified immediately. If you prefer cashmere bouquet to camé, please contact Miss Carmen on extension 1108. Thank you, Martin L. Ken Setter, assistant manager. Dear Miss Carmen, who the hell left 54 little bars of soap in my room? I came in last night and found 54 little bars of camé. I don't want 54 little bars of camé. I want my one damn bar of bath-sized dial. Do you realize, including the cashmere bouquet, I now have 58 little bars of soap in here? All I want is my bath-sized dial. Give me back my bath-sized dial. S. Berman. Dear Mr. Berman, you complained of too much soap in your room, so I had it removed. Then you complained to Mr. Ken Setter that all your soaps were missing, so I personally returned them. The 24 camés which had been taken, plus the three camés you are supposed to receive daily. Obviously, your maid did not know I had returned the soap, so she also brought 24 camés, plus the three daily camés. I don't know where you got the idea that this hotel issues bath-sized dials. I was able to locate some hotel-sized bath-sized ivory, which I left in your room. We are trying our best here to satisfy you. Elaine Carmen, housekeeper. Dear Miss Carmen, Just a brief note to bring you up to date. On my latest soap inventory. As of today, I possess, on shelf under medicine cabinet, 18 Camay in 4 stacks of 4 and 1 stack of 2. On cleanest dispenser, 11 Camay in 2 stacks of 4 and 1 stack of 3. On bedroom dresser, 1 stack of 3 cashmere bouquet, 1 stack of 4 hotel size, bath size ivory, 8 Camay in 2 stacks of 4. Inside medicine cabinet, 14 Camay in 3 stacks of 4 and 1 stack of 2. In shower soap dish, 6 Camay, very moist. On northeast corner of tub, 1 cashmere bouquet, slightly used. On northwest corner of tub, 6 Camay and 2 stacks of 3. Please ask Kathy when she services in my room to make sure the stacks are neatly piled and dusted. Also, please advise her that stacks of more than 4 have a tendency to tip. May I suggest that my bedroom windowsill is not in use and will make an excellent spot for future soap delivery. One more item. I have purchased another bar of bath-sized dial, which I am keeping in the hotel vault in order to avoid future misunderstandings. S. Berman.
By far, the hardest part of living in hotels is room service. You're not going to get through these people no matter what you do. I have traveled pretty much all over the world. And I'll tell you right now, whatever country you're in, if you're in a hotel, they brought someone in from another country to take the room service over. Money, room service. I beg your pardon, I thought I dialed room service. Yeah, room service, money. Can help you? Do I have room service here? Yeah, room service, money, help you. You're really embarrassed by this. I apologize, but I just don't know what help you means. What are you saying to me, sir? Room service, money, you want something? Can I have that again, please? Room service, money, you want something? One more time, sir. You want something? Yes, this Jew would like something, yes. What you want, please? Well, I'd like some eggs. Ace. Eggs. Ace. Is that the same as eggs? Yes, ace, ace. How'd you light in? I beg your pardon? How'd you light in? I'm not getting that, sir. How'd you light in? How'd you lie, you ace? Pry, boy, pooch, how'd you light in? Oh, yeah, I'm getting it now, yes. I'll have my ace pooch. I beg your pardon, I can't understand you.